everyone, and welcome to the Extreme TIG channel. So for today's video, guys, I'm gonna go 304 stainless 12 inch flange and 12 inch reducer to 6 inch. It's a 304 material, SCAT 10. This is my partner pipe fitter Kyle. He's an excellent pipe fitter. He's gonna do some prep and fit up for me. As you can see, I always like to go with a feather edge. Some guys like to do just 16 land, you know, just to prevent some internal undercuts. For seam, guys always make sure it's blended out, especially that part. You always go inch for that seam. Once we check the level both sides, we're gonna go with 1/8 gap. I'm gonna use 4 tacks. Now, this, as I said, this is controlled environment. It's perfect condition, so it's gonna be perfect fit up. Kyle is checking for any high low inside with his bare hands. That's the best way to check for any high lows. If you got any high low, you can feel it right away and just split the difference all the way around. As you can see, it's pretty much perfect. Once you got fit up, you know, in a shop or on a table, there's no excuses, you know, for bad fit up. Don't let your pipe fitter have any excuses, you know, especially if you got on fittings, there's always some transitioning or something. So okay, so for the bridge tack, it's a 532 stick, stainless stick. I just knocked the flax off and 4 pieces. Make sure when you weld, the weld stays inside the bevel, don't go on the outside of the pipe, as it looks bad, it's not professional. I'm gonna use a toothbrush, call it my little toothbrush, clean all those tacks, make sure they're nice and shiny. As you can see, no matter if it's a new fitting, guys, make sure it's always clean in and out, especially on the stainless. Even though it's nice and shiny, it can be really dirty, especially with 304 material. Okay, I'm gonna use a 10 inch gasket, 600. The reason, one main reason is to protect the face of the flange, and the other reason is to reduce that hole so I don't have to waste too much aluminum tape. I'm gonna poke hole in the middle and holes all the way around. That's gonna be my vent site. All that purge is gonna go here to push all that oxygen outside the pipe. Okay, and I'm gonna set up in the roller. It's a handheld, it's a handmade roller. It's not automatic one. You gotta spin it with your hand. Safety first, guys. Even though it's a SCAT 10, it's a heavy flange. Make sure it's really tight and bolted. You don't want that thing drop on your leg. Okay, so for the purge, for my argon hose, I'm just gonna connect diffuser. Just the way how it is, disperses all that argon evenly inside. That's one of the reasons, and prevents for any, if you got any issues, you know, with the flow on your argon, it's just gonna block and put it evenly inside that pipe. Tape around and wait for 5 to 10 minutes. My purge, this setup, it's around 25-30 on a flow meter. This is how I check for the purge. If purge is good, you go by inches, you know, inches, you measure the distance from the lighter to that hole. That's how you know for your purge. I'm not going to lower down, I'm going to leave it around 25-30, even though you have some turbulence. But if it's smaller pipe, you might have some turbulences. That's why you put diffuser, and because it's a 12 inch, shouldn't be a big deal. Okay, for the setup, lift arc, zero arc control, and 95 for my root pass. And Kyle is setting up another fitting for me, so I'm happy. It's gonna be some welding. Okay, so for the initial one, I'm gonna start on the top, and this is the only technique I'm gonna use. It's gonna be dipping technique. I'm just gonna put deep in the middle and stretch that puddle. Deep in the middle and stretch that puddle. It's just stretch that puddle left, right. The good thing about this is you got clear vision what's going on. You can see both edges on both sides, they're burning. Putting evenly, you know, that root inside, it's forming as how it should. Gravity helps a lot, that's why I'm welding around 12 o'clock. The gravity helps to form your root evenly and also purge. That's one of the reasons why I got 25-30. Someone might say, it's maybe too high. No, there's a reason why. And the reason is to prevent for your root to sag even more. Sag it, you know, especially when you're welding on a top, it sag down. So that strong purge is actually preventing that. So you're gonna have nice, even, pretty much root consistent. The thing I'm also didn't mention, I'm gonna weld between tacks. I'm not gonna touch any tacks, so all four tacks is gonna stay. I'm welding in between them, so I'm gonna put four welds around before I even start the grinder. I don't want to start any grinder, then you put air inside, then you gotta wait to purge again a couple minutes, you know, just a little bit time consuming. That's one thing. The other thing also, it's gonna pull, it's gonna shrink, it's gonna close your gap, the flange is not gonna stay level. With this technique, flange is gonna stay perfect as you fit it up, and this is how it's gonna stay, and it's not gonna close the gap on you. So this is really important. It doesn't matter if it's on a table, the same thing applies in the field as well, guys. If you put four tacks, try to weld, you know, in between, and then get rid of tacks later. That's how your gap is gonna stay even. And you always go, as I show you, I always go like minimum half inch length for the tacks. Same thing, dipping technique. You see the gap is even, didn't close at all, which is common thing on a stainless. It doesn't matter what thickness, it can be SCAD 10, it can be, you know, SCAD 160, it's gonna pull, it's gonna shrink, it's gonna close on you. This is a little view from the outside, as I show you, it's around 12 o'clock. This is where I'm trying to keep and roll with one hand. It's 332 filler wire, that's what I'm using for root, 332 308L. That's gonna stay the same for the root, for the fill, and for the cap. Also, for my torch, it's a Miller 150, cup size 8, 1/8 tungsten. And I got nice brand new shiny TIG gloves. I got connection in the tool grip. Okay, as I said, didn't touch any of those tacks. Now I'm gonna use a grinder. I'm gonna take the tacks out. You see, because I stayed inside the bevel, there's no any marks outside the pipe, which is important, especially when you're welding later. You know, you don't want to have any. You want to have nice and clear path of travel for your cup. If you walk the cup, you don't want to have any obstacles inside or outside. And also looks good, looks professional. You know, in some places they can get you. You can get you in trouble if you got any grinding marks or arc marks outside on the pipe. And for my tie-ins, as you see, I started like half inch before and start adding rod, And for my tie-in, here before I reached my tie-in, I'm gonna slow down, I'm gonna pause, make sure both edges are burned, the middle is filled with a filler rod. You kind of pause here a little bit, add rod is needed. You kind of go by the feeling, you know, it's all about a little bit, it's all about a little bit also about experience, and just go half inch after. Make sure your pipe is always clean, run a buffing wheel, clean that root pass, and now I'm gonna do head pass. Just gonna switch my tungsten, as you can see, make sure it's really, really sharp. When the tungsten is sharp, it's easier to manipulate that puddle. I like stainless. Stainless is always clean, way cleaner than the carbon or any other material. There's a little bit fine tunes, you know, for settings, for machine setup, for purge, for even for the argon flow through your torch, the size of the cup, the length of your stick out. For everybody, for everyone works differently, you know, that's something you gotta find by for yourself. What works for you the best, only I can show you what works for me. I always go at least like 15 mil for my stick out. Keep that rod inside the puddle, always connected. You know, I found out that 308, as soon as you pull it out from that weld zone, you know, it gets contaminated, and once you try to bring it back, you just got all that impurities, and it's a little bit, give you a little bit difficulties, at least for you know, for a half an inch of length. And I did that's it. This is filled to flash. I'm just gonna run again buffing wheel, make it clean, nice and shiny. You know what, now I'm gonna let it cool down a little bit, as I gotta watch for my between passes, for my temperature, for heat input. And that's it, this is the root. There's a couple spots, as you can see, that there was tines, but other than that, root is solid, root is good, nice and thick. That's how it should be. Lots of meat. You don't have to worry for the sag back, even though I was doing one pass hot and filled to flash, so there's no any sign of the sag back, which is good. And because the purge flow also, this is 115 amps for the cap. As I said, I didn't change anything. Everything is 332, the same filler rod, 1/8 tungsten, cup size 8. And for the cap, you know, that's a cherry on the top. Nice and even, consistent steps. Keep an eye on your edges on both sides, make sure they're even. As I said, keep that rod constantly connected to that puddle. Don't try to lose connections. As soon as you pull it out of the weld zone, it gets contaminated. It's gonna give you a little bit hard time bring it back in, as you're gonna have some impurities. It's a little bit harder to, you know, stretch that puddle, as it's like an oilish on the top. It's perfect. If you got any weld like this, you know, if it's not a field, then it's a perfect time, you know, to practice, to implement something new. That's why I'm making this video, to help you guys out, to learn something new, you know, to progress. Lots of people ask, you know, how long does it take to weld like this? Or I never consider myself some kind of superstar or the best welder in the world. I'm here just sharing my experience. It doesn't comes overnight. It takes years, thousands and thousands of pipes get me to here where I am, so I can teach you, you know, share my experience with you guys. And every feedback from you that my welding or my video helps you guys to get a better job or a better paid job or pass the test, that means the world to me. And this is the whole meaning of my YouTube channel. Thank you guys. I hope you like it. Hope you enjoy it. Hope you learn something new, you know. And see you in the next one, guys. Take care.